Our land is very long and narrow. It stretches from Camden Hill State Park down a long hill.
It's exquisitely beautiful here. I've got really pretty gardens and rose gardens.
This land was made by a glacier that dropped some pretty nice soil where my grapevines are.
Our farm's very special. It's on a mountainside overlooking a valley.
It runs in a north-south direction. Our vineyard has a nice crown to it, and we slope slightly southerly, which is nice. The ground heats up really well for the grapes. So we've got 6 acres of grapevines, which consist of about 25 varieties. The idea is to prune them up away from the ground and as high up onto the wire as possible. The vines will grow a lot, but they won't put out as much fruit. And the trick is to balance the amount of fruit with the amount of foliage. And it takes approximately 1 square foot of foliage to ripen 1 pound of grapes.
When you look from our beautiful old colonial cape, looking down our valley past our little farm pond, you're looking straight into the vineyard. From our wine tasting room that's housed in our 18th century barn, you look out across the vineyard. Everything that we have looks out across our vineyard. The vineyard is the focus of our property. One of the things that I try to do is I buy things for the shop that I like. I don't buy anything. And I talk to local craftsmen about things that they might like to put in.
It's really fun because people are tasting, they ask questions, and you actually learn something about winemaking and what makes the winery tick.
We're giving them the chance to decide for themselves whether they like it well enough to buy it. And when they do buy it, they know exactly what they've gotten.
Right now we produce about 2,000 gallons, more or less, which is something in the range of 10,000 bottles.
In the summertime, it's a mad rush because we're getting it out of the cellar every day, we're selling it that day, we bring more out of the cellar the next.
It's a contest between us and the people from France. It's just trying to make them sweat. I kind of want my wines to be a little more rustic and down to earth. Our winery is fairly low tech. It's old world style, but I think the flavors are pretty well received. I try to make a wine for everybody. So I make a couple of dry ones, dry whites, then some semi-sweet wines that can actually be red or white or anything in between. The wine tasting is very important because it allows people to actually taste the wine and make a decision as far as how things are fermented and what vessels I use is kind of an artistic judgment based on flavor and what I expect something will come out like. Certain things like Chardonnay and Cabernet are generally fermented in the barrel and then aged in the barrel as well for from 6 months to a year. Some Cabernets are aged as much as 18 months in the barrel. Any wines that you really want to kick the fruitiness, what they call forward, you ferment in stainless steel at a cool temperature and they retain real crisp fruit flavor. I used a little bit of French oak, some French oak barrels, and mostly American oak barrels.
When somebody tastes a bottle of our wine and they're surprised at how good it is, and they see that look on their face of surprise and excitement, I know that person has just had a good experience here and they're going to buy a bottle of our wine. Part of having a shop with a winery is to give people a broader experience. The gift shop is my world. I go and buy all of the gifts that go in. Meanwhile, John is spending half a day in the vineyard as well. He's down there pruning and weeding and taking care of the vineyard while I'm taking care of the bed and breakfast guests and the shop. We'd like to have people leave Celador Winery.
And that's it. Sounds a little sappy, but
they've tasted good friends.